too low, too low.
Croeso friends, first of all, before I do anything else, I want to say thank you so much for being so amazing and supportive of the break that I ended up taking. I didn't realize exactly how much I needed one until I took it. It turns out that working for an entire year without a break tires one out. Who knew? So going forward, I'm planning on scheduling a break at least every 6 months, and if that's not quite enough, I'll switch to one every season. Hopefully that will give us some time to do more YouTube lives. That was really popular and everybody seemed to like it. So, on to my actual content for today. There's actually a lot, more than I normally make for one video, but we're down to the wire on April Fool's time, so it's all going in this one video. And while I'm thinking about it, please make sure to check out all of the other videos in the April Fool's Fabric playlist. We have some amazing work on there. I'll link that up in the cards and also down in the description. So, as you may remember in my last video, I made a set of 1780s stays in this fantastic anatomical heart print from Piratical on Spoonflower. Well, I didn't have anything to wear with these stays at all, so obviously I needed to make some things in order to go with them. I had some of the same linen that I used for the binding on those stays that I knew I wanted to use for a petticoat or skirt. But I also needed some skirt support because the last quarter of the 18th century silhouette has this very distinctive shape, this rounded conical torso and skirts with fullness mostly to the sides and back. So now on the docket we have a skirt, a bum pad, and of course I can't make an 18th century outfit without making a set of pockets. It just can't do it. So everyone, grab your cuppas and tell me in the comments either what you're drinking or what you wish you were drinking, and let's dive into today's projects. Oh, that got cold.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining me today. I'm really quite happy with the way this entire outfit came together. I know I said I'd be angling back towards pre-Enlightenment clothing for a while, and I am, but the fun that I had making this stuff makes me think that I'm probably going to revisit this era in the future too. I also have some fun upcoming things to tell you about. Firstly, we're coming up on 4,000 subscribers, and OMG, that feels like so many. It's been a little while since I did any kind of giveaway, and I think I'm going to plan on doing a little something for when we hit 5,000 croissants. There's still a ways to go, but I wanted to let everyone know that it's on the horizon. And the other thing is, I've seen a couple of questions about a CoCoVid event this year, and I have good news for you. We are putting together another online interactive event, but its new name will be the CosTube Symposium, or COSY for short, and it will take place August 19th through 22nd on YouTube and Instagram, just like CoCoVid last year, so mark your calendars. As we get closer, I will have some more information for you, but if you want to stay in the loop, you can join the COSY Facebook group, which I will link in the description box below. I'm really excited about this year. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I upload every other Friday, and if you like reminders, be sure to ring the notification bell. If you want to find me on social media, I am at Opus Elenae everywhere, even on TikTok, and I will put all of those links in the description box below, along with a link to my Ko-fi, where I post exclusive content for donors, and where I have opened a small web shop if you would like to help support the channel and production assistant Bran a little more directly. But for now, friends, be kind, do the work, continue supporting marginalized people, and keep creating. Hwyl!